LDWMAC. This is your boy, the Coach Show, live on the Coach Show, the Coach Show Live. Y'all know the routine. Forgive the background noise and let's just get right into it. My goodness gracious, this fight right here. Oh, Jessica versus Manon Ferrio. Listen, y'all, this fight right here, this is definitely gonna be a very important fight for Manon Ferrio because it's gonna get her inside the top 10. But then this is gonna get Jessica outside of the top 10. And this is kind of what we all been wanting, a lot of us. It's just, man, we're so tired of these fighters that's just there in the top 10. I mean, we're sick of them. And it's time for these older fighters to go, okay? I mean, you know, granted, if Casey O'Neill can take care of Roxanne Modafferi, okay, if Casey O'Neill can take care of Roxanne Modafferi, then we're one step closer to getting all of these fighters out of the top spots. We're one step closer. Now, we just need Manon Ferrio to get Jessica out of there. But I'm going to tell you, I'm going to go ahead and break this fight down just, you know, pretty much. It's pretty an open shut case here. Jessica, she's going to do everything she can to try to box Manon Ferrio. Jessica, her kicks, she's got an average array of kicks. They're not like anything special. They're not great. Jessica, she's very durable, though. Very durable. She can take a lot of damage. But she's going to try to come forward, and she's just going to try to box. She's going to try to throw hands with Ferrio. Ferrio, she's too fast, man. Ferrio got a pure speed advantage. She's going to go in there, and she's going to just strike circles around Jessica. She's going to do it. And Jessica won't be able to deal with the speed. So Jessica, she's going to get frustrated, and she's going to go for a clinch. She's going to try to grab Manon Ferrio. She's going to try to press Manon Ferrio up against the cage. Jessica isn't known much for her wrestling. She's not much of a wrestler. She knows how to wrestle, but that's not something that, you know, she's like over the top great at. And I've noticed too, when Jessica is posting to social media, Jessica has been doing a lot of wrestling. So I'm thinking that the game plan for this fight may be to try to get Manon Ferrio to the ground. And I think that a lot of people are truly underestimating Manon Ferrio's ground game. She's very good on the ground. And I don't understand, like, people don't quite get it. They just think, well, she's a striker. She's pretty decent on the ground, and she's strong. And I think Jessica, she's going to have a tough time. Now, this fight is very pivotal for Manon because now what people are going to do, they're going to compare how Valentina fought Jessica versus how Manon fought Jessica, okay? And I do have to add that this version of Jessica, I don't know if this version of Jessica is a better version. It could be. We just have to see. We have to really see what Jessica doing, okay? But, you know, I know Valentina fought Jessica, damn near 3 years ago, two or 3 years ago, Valentina fought her. And, you know, Jessica was actually on a nice win streak. She was like 4-0 leading up to the title fight before she fought Valentina. And this Jessica now just been getting beat, getting her ass whooped all around the octagon. But still, nonetheless, this is going to be a good fight for Manon. I want Manon to win this fight because I really want some of these young fighters that's hungry. Well, Manon not young. She's 31. But still, I want fighters like Manon to get up in there, man. I just need to see some different faces, some different challenges to the champ. That's all. Excuse me, fanboys. Allergic to them. God, dog. But yeah, you know, I just want to see some different faces fight the champ. I really thought that Taylor Santos would go ahead and just make that call out of Valentina, but man, she didn't do it. She didn't do it, you know, and it's irritating because we want fighters, new fighters to come into the fray, to add a storyline, to add some challenge to the champ. That's what we want. And, you know, I feel like Taylor Santos squandered that opportunity. And, you know, you have a lot of people saying, well, Taylor not ready. She's not ready. She is ready. You're 28 years old. You've been fighting your whole damn life. You ain't ready to fight the champion? They're going to give you enough time for a decent training camp. They're going to give it to you. Okay? That's what they're going to do. But nonetheless, I don't want to digress in this video. I think Manon Ferrio being 31 years old, I suspect, okay, if she can defeat Jessica, if she can do it, I don't think she'll call out Valentina. I don't think she'll do that. However, I do think that she'll call out somebody in the top five. And I think that's what she's going to need to do, okay? You know, Manon Ferrio, she's not getting younger. before you know it, she'll be 35. She's 31, she'll be 35. And we know that this is a young person game. We know that she's at that age now where she got to start looking for opportunities. She got to look for them. And being looking at her age, I won't even, you know, if she call out the champ, I'd be like, oh, well, you know, it's a little premature. But I won't be totally like, you know, oh, man, she shouldn't have did it because of her age. Okay? I mean, how many years does Manon Ferrio have left in MMA? I mean, realistically. Okay? What, 4 or 5? Maybe. So she got to act. She got to be Just Guy. She don't get another opportunity. She got to be Just Guy. She got to do it. And she got to do it in March when they fight. Okay? She got to hope that nobody has to pull out because of an injury. Nobody gets sick. It's just a lot of stuff riding on Manon Ferriot's opportunity. And she knows it is a big opportunity. Manon Ferriot is going to set a lot of traps for Just Guy. She's going to set them. Jessica Eye, she's very prone to being caught in a trap. She's prone to it. Sometimes she will come straight ahead, you know. She'll use her offense as defense. Like Jessica will throw a lot of jabs. She'll throw a lot of jabs and she'll just throw punches. And she'll throw a whole lot of punches in your face. So it's pretty much going to blind you. So you'll just try to defend the punches. Well, that's Jessica's defense. However, though, Manon, she's a pretty decent counterpuncher. So I don't know if Jessica is going to continue to do that, man. I don't know if she won't. And I don't know. I've never really seen Jessica I make adjustments in the octagon. I've never seen her do it. It's almost like either Jessica can beat you and she's going to have an advantage over you, a strength and power advantage, or she just can't beat you. And then Jessica will go into survival mode. Honestly, I think this fight will probably be one of Manon's easier fights. I mean, I think it is. I mean, Jessica I is not like, it's not like she's this dynamic, awesome fighter with all these skill sets. Nah, it's not it. Manon's going to go in there and do what she's supposed to do, okay? And then, after that, who should Manon fight in the top five? Who? Should it be Manon versus Jessica Andrade? I mean, should it be Manon versus Caitlin Chikagian? Who? And, you know, damn, where is Caitlin Chikagian at? Caitlin ain't fought in some time. Like, damn, where the hell is Caitlin at? Hey, guys. Y'all let me know what you think.